Green tech is technology, is a technology industry that is aware of the social and environmental costs and works to reduce and minimize these in all the decisions that we make, and is clear and transparent about how we are doing that, so people can actually see that we are being responsible professionals. I think sustainable and planet-friendly tech looks a lot more kind of human scale. So it's things like, say, stuff at a kind of human scale. When you're looking at cities, it might be things like, say, bikes over cars, for example, or it might be better use of existing resources. And I think it's one that kind of represents, I think it's stuff which is designed for more, not just the end user, but it's more for like the entire community or the kind of wider kind of the wider system, really. I think what we need to have as professionals is to see climate as a key competency and to learn to think more systemically. And to give some examples, we need to look beyond just at our own organisation. We also need to think about what actions we enable through our work. So if we need to transition away from a fossil fuel economy to a zero carbon one, we need to be prepared to make decisions about not propping up an old fossil fuel economy and make in addition to thinking about innovation. I think this is the key things. It's decisions as well as innovation if you want to, well, face the greatest challenge that we've ever faced. So there's different levels at this where it looks like. If you think about the kind of platform that you might be using, there are choices you can make through your choice of technology that will give you, say, 10 to 100 or 1,000 times increase in the efficiency compared to what you were using before, just by using a different language or designing things in a different way. And this is something that we as engineers are familiar with already, but previously we haven't really made the connection between, well, what faces us as a kind of planetary challenge in terms of CO2 and the kind of unintended impacts of what we do. So there are absolutely changes you can make there, but there are also changes in how you deliver a service in the first place. So rather than just having micro optimizations at a kind of programming level, you can think about, well, do we actually need to have someone fly somewhere in the first place if we can make it possible to have, say, the same kind of outcomes from, say, a video conference call or something like that. I think we need to act in a way which is more informed by the science. And if we know that we need to transition away from a kind of high carbon economy, then I think we should be taking steps to speed that transition and not prolong or keep the existing kind of, say, fossil fueled economy going. So that would say be investing in fuel cells rather than helping extract oil out of the ground. These are examples of deliberate decisions that we need to make. So we need decisions as well as innovation. I think through technology we can make better use of the existing resources that we do have, so that we don't need to dig so much out of the ground. Or we can think in terms of a more kind of closed loop. So at the end of the life cycle of products or services that we have, we think about how to reclaim these materials so they can be reused. Or if we're going to be sourcing power from certain places to kind of support our services, we'll realize when is the best time to do that, when power is greenest and cheapest, for example. I think companies can do two things. They can lead in terms of transparency to make it easier for people who are looking to find an organization to work with to make the right choices, so that companies which are doing the hard work to actually hit the targets informed by science are rewarded for this. I think that's one thing that you can do. And I also think that being more aware, allowing employees to take the kind of greener choice is actually a really, really good and important thing to do. So that might be from changing how people travel or supporting more, say, climate compatible ways of traveling, say, supporting, say, travel by train over the plane, for example, and building that into how you work.